So the School of Natural and Applied Sciences is divided up into various departments, some of which are natural sciences, some of which are mathematics, and some of which are applied sciences. I would say that one of our key strengths are the faculty that reside in those departments. The departments, to some extent, are a little bit artificial, but I can say this, that what we're trying to do is to work together as a faculty, and I think Belhaven is unique in that regard, because what we do is we really try to say, okay, well, how does chemistry impact biology? How does physics impact biology? How does biology impact the society, the greater society? How do we use tools such as those provided by computer science to be able to solve real-world problems? And we use that in the context of really trying to get students involved with multidisciplinary approaches to their studies. So faculty and students work together primarily in the form of classes, but we have a lot of very much one-on-one experiences with students. So from that perspective, we have traditional lectures and classroom environments and experiences and laboratory experiences, as well as field experiences, and where we have a faculty member with students, and typically 10 to 12 students at a time in a classroom or in a laboratory or in a field trip. And those students get a lot of hands-on interactions with the faculty on the things that they're working on. And I think that one of the things that's interesting is the ability to working one-on-one with students. Students can also interact with faculty in research projects that they're involved with. We have a number of research active faculty that have partnerships and collaborations with places like the University of Mississippi Medical Center, the Army Corps of Engineers nearby in Vicksburg and other places, and even private businesses. And there's a real interaction, kind of a hands-on approach to learning. In order to do modern science, you have to have great facilities and equipment and instrumentation, and Belhaven has that. But more than just having a bunch of empty rooms or really large pieces of equipment that are kind of what I like to call black boxes, where students don't understand what they're really doing, Belhaven has smarter facilities. We design them to be very efficient, very extremely high tech, but the real goal is to make sure that all of our instrumentation is accessible to students. Our purpose in having equipment and great buildings and ultra clean water and all kinds of safety in our laboratories is to make sure that students have the most high tech, relevant experience that they possibly can. And that means that they have hands-on instruction into very high-tech pieces of equipment. A lot of our students leave here and they go right into industry, if that's their choosing, but some of them go into medical school, dental school. But regardless of what their chosen path is, they are equipped and prepared in modern equipment and instrumentation to be able to meet the challenges of the future. So there are a number of schools in the area, in the region, which are really focused on science. And what I mean by focused on science and mathematics is that they're focused on the stuff of science. And there is no question that Belhaven can meet them toe-to-toe with regard to the quality of information, content delivery, and training. But I think that what really makes Belhaven special is that we can also ask something about the ethical aspects of science. From both a Christian worldview perspective and also from a societal sustainability question. So we're really here trying to ask the question, you know, how does a student's scientific training engage with the sustainability of society overall? And also, how are we involved with the tending of the garden, so to speak? You know, what are our responsibilities as scientists to make sure that we're doing good science, ethical science, and not just necessarily going after, better product yields, bigger money, et cetera. All those things are certainly important. I think there is an ethical question related to Christian worldview that we also address. We work really, really hard to make sure that students have opportunities to get real world training and experience. We know that a student's training doesn't all happen in the cocoon of academia. So from that perspective, we like to make sure that students get summer internships, doing research. A number of our students have research experiences that are paid experiences. And in some cases, we've paired students up with internships that were unpaid, but were extremely high quality business opportunities or academic opportunities. So we've had students working with Nobel Prize winners. We've had students going and working with the Army Corps of Engineers during the summer, working on high-level projects of environmental remediation. We've had a number of students working with local businesses, and we're just really proud of our students, and they get great experience from that, and they use that experience to get jobs into the future as they get near graduation.